The 139th Knights of Columbus Supreme Convention wraps up today. And last night, the new Supreme Knight delivered his first annual report. Supreme Knight Patrick Kelly says the end of the pandemic is an invitation to action, adding the organization's work is just beginning. The Knights of Columbus is the world's largest Catholic fraternal service organization with 1.9 million members. The Knights of Columbus is also a sponsor of EWTN News Nightly. Joining us now is Patrick Kelly, the Supreme Knight of the Knights of Columbus. Supreme Knight Kelly, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it. As we mentioned, you say the coronavirus pandemic is an invitation to action. Explain to us what you mean by that.
Well, in the Knights of Columbus, we responded to the coronavirus pandemic through a program called Leave No Neighbor Behind. And we provided food and assistance and blood to those in need. But we made an extra effort to reach out to members of our parishes and members of our councils who perhaps were shut in at this time. And that was very important, I think, to that human touch, to reach out to people and just to ask them, how are you doing? How are you getting through this? So that was one of the great programs that we responded to COVID with.
Yeah, and that is so important. That's wonderful. I know your annual report also made reference to something called creative courage. Can you talk to us about that and some of the ways you want the Knights of Columbus to exhibit creative courage?
Yeah, so we pulled the theme of our convention, Called to Creative Courage, from Pope Francis's letter in which he begins the year of St. Joseph, and he mentions Joseph's creative courage. And we thought that it was a perfect way for us as Catholic men to respond to the great needs that are around us and the difficulties that we have, to be courageous in our response, but also to be creative. And so that's what we titled our convention as, Called to Creative Courage. And that's what we do as Knights. I mean, we meet needs. Where there's a need, there's a knight, and we try to meet those needs and help those who are in need, help Catholic families with the struggles that they have. And Lord knows that there are a lot of struggles in the world today.
Yeah, you had mentioned St. Joseph, and I know your first act upon becoming Supreme Knight was to consecrate your administration to St. Joseph. Can you tell us more about that, why you chose St. Joseph, what you feel he symbolizes for the Knights, and also what he means to you personally?
Yeah, St. Joseph, I think, is the perfect example for the Knights of Columbus in the sense that he was a man of obedience. So he received messages and inspiration. But not only did he receive them, he acted on them. So he was a man of obedience and a man of action. And we feel very strongly within the Knights that is what we are called to be as well. But also, he was guardian of the family. And I think that's so important for us as the Knights of Columbus, as an organization of Catholic men in service to one another, but also in service to the Catholic family. And so St. Joseph is a perfect example for us to follow. And in many ways, our founder, Blessed Michael McGivney, was also in the mold of St. Joseph.
Yeah, and before I let you go, anything that you would like to touch upon as far as the convention so far?
Well, we've had a wonderful convention. I think the highlight is yesterday we had a votive mass of Blessed Michael McGivney, which was our opening mass of the convention. And it was very, very beautiful. It was in St. Mary's Church, which is where Blessed Michael McGivney founded the Knights of Columbus. So it was deeply meaningful for us to be in the church where Father McGivney was the parish priest and founded this organization. And here we are 140 years later, and that vision, that founding vision, continues. And I think also the beatification of Father McGivney really is a sign of the Lord not only confirming where the Knights of Columbus have been, but also showing us a path forward.
Well, thank you so much for your time today. Patrick Kelly, the Supreme Knight of the Knights of Columbus. Thank you again.
Thank you, Tracy.